Good morning, students. Myself, Megha Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Sagar Institute of Science and Technology, Gandhinagar, Bhopal. Today, we are here to discuss about the fifth unit topic of Geotechnical Engineering, that is your machine foundations. So, first of all, the whole lecture is divided into three parts. First is the introduction. Second one is the types of machine foundations. And the third part is the basic terminologies which we need to study during the design of machine foundations. So generally, what does a foundation mean? What does a foundation means in a building? So the foundation is the substructure of any building that transmits the whole load from the superstructure to the stable ground surface below, such as to carry all the loads and transmit it to a larger area beneath that building. So, in this subject, we have discussed about shallow foundation, we have also discussed about deep foundations, we have discussed about how do we calculate the bearing capacity in shallow foundation, how do we calculate the bearing capacity in deep foundations, we have also discussed about soil stabilization, techniques for improving the bearing capacity of the soils, we have also discussed about soil exploration techniques and all. So generally these foundations are special type of foundations that are different in comparison to your shallow foundation and deep foundations. Generally shallow foundation and deep foundations are subjected to static loading only. Okay, so the loading can be divided into two parts: static loading and dynamic loading. The static loading means a load that comes onto a structure for an instant only. Okay, so the shallow foundation and deep foundations are designed for a static load only. But when we design a machine foundation, it is subjected to dynamic load also. So the foundations which are subject, so the machine foundations are types of foundations which are subjected to dynamic loads only. Okay, and from where these dynamic loads come? The dynamic loads are resulted from various causes such as vibratory motion of the machines, movement of vehicles, impact of hammers, earthquake, winds, waves, nuclear blast, mine explosion and pile driving, etc. These are all the causes from which the dynamic loads come. Okay, it can be the dynamic load can be a machine foundation can be designed to resist this dynamic load, and it would come from vibratory motion of the machine. It can come from the movement of vehicles. It can come from the impact of hammers, from earthquake also, from winds, from waves, nuclear blast, mine explosion, pile driving, etc. So these dynamic loads, as a foundation works, the top of the building carries the load and it transmits the load element to element wise to the substructure, and the substructure distributes the load to a larger area. Like in this also, the dynamic loads are transmitted to the foundation and their effect on the strata below, and the load transferred below the foundation is transferred to a larger area, and the transfer of that load to a larger area can be studied by theory of vibrations and the principle of soil dynamics. Okay, so the
analysis is not simple as we have done in shallow foundations. We have estimated the amount of bearing capacity of the soil. Okay, we have also analyzed how the failures can occur. The failure can occur through local shear failure, the failure can occur through general shear failure, and the failure can occur through punching shear failure also. Therefore, the whole analysis is very complex and it is not done by simple theories. Okay, so basically the machine foundation, these were all the causes of the special types of foundation design that can be designed due to a dynamic loads, and these are the causes of dynamic. So specially the machine foundations, when we discuss about the special type of foundations and the special type of and the special type of foundation is termed as machine foundations. And these machine foundations are subjected to dynamic forces caused by the machines. And how the dynamic forces by the machine is caused? Due to the vibration motion of the machine. So these dynamic forces that are coming from the machine is then transmitted from machines to the foundation, and then foundation to a distribution of the load to a larger area. Although now, why does this vibration occurs? This vibration occurs as the moving part of the machines are designed as to be balanced. But in practice, the balanced part does not take place, and which results in a formation of an eccentricity of a rotating parts. And when the two forces are not balanced, then we see an oscillating force. Okay, and from that oscillating force, vibration occurs, and from vibration motion of the machine, the dynamic force comes into action, and these machine foundations are being subjected to dynamic loads. Okay, and one thing that we need to keep in mind, that the machine foundations are additionally designed for dynamic loading. That means in addition to the static loading. Static loading will come, but along with that, dynamic loading will also come. Okay. Next point is, here basically the types of machines. Generally, the machines are divided into three types. Okay. So when you have a machine which produces a periodic unbalanced force, such as reciprocating engines and compressors. And to keep this in mind, the machine speed is generally less. And how much it is less? It is less than 600 rpm. In these machines, the rotatory motion of the crank is converted into translatory motion. So the unbalanced force varies sinusoidally. Sinusoidally means the you all can imagine the wave part, sine curve or cosine curve, like that the unbalanced force varies. Okay, so there is a, first of all, you have low speed machines. For what are the types of low speed machines? Reciprocating engines and compressor. And the speed of such machines is generally less than 600 rpm. In these machines, the unbalanced forces causes sinusoidal. So first type of machine is your low speed machines. Next type of machine is your intermediate type of machines, intermediate speed machines. And these machines are generally produces impact loads. Okay. And the impact loads machine, we can say, such as punch press and forge hammers, are the intermediate speed machines. And in this particular machine, the dynamic force attains a peak value in a very short time period and dies out gradually. That means you can observe a type of an impact. When an impact comes on a particular machine, then the dynamic force attains a peak in a very short time period, but then it gradually dies out. The speed is generally between 60 to 150 blows per minute. So the first one was low speed machines, the second one is your intermediate speed machines, and the last one types of machines is high speed machines such as turbines and rotary compressor. And the speed of such types of machine is more than 3000 rpm. So the basic need of understanding what does which type of machine is in which speed, the idea and the idea behind to study this types of machines are you have to design the machine foundation for two types of loading. First one is your static loading and second one is your dynamic loading. The dynamic loading comes from the vibration of the machines. So the more would be the speed of the machines, more would be the dynamic action of the machine, and for that criteria you have to design the machine foundation accordingly. So you all have to keep in mind dynamic loading plus static loading. Static loading is the self weight of the machine, okay, and the dynamic loading is the vibration that is coming from the speed of the machine, okay. So the dynamic loading depends upon these types of machines. Next, we have different types of machine foundation. So generally you all have seen certain different types of machine foundation. You would see first one is your block type machine foundation. What does a block type machine foundation has and how it is being classified? A block type machine foundation is a solid block that is being formed in a means of pedestal and over which a machine is being installed. So a block foundation it consists of a pedestal resting on a footing, and the foundation generally has a large mass and a small natural frequency. What does natural frequency mean? That we will discuss in the next slides. Okay, next we have the box type foundation. The box type foundation consists of a hollow concrete block like this, hollow concrete block, and it is rested upon a foundation, and over this box the machine is being installed. Usually the mass of this foundation is less and the natural frequency is more. So a box type and block type. We have discussed two types of foundation, machine foundations. Next we have wall type machine foundation. In a wall type of machine foundation, so we have discussed three types of machine foundations. We have discussed block type of machine foundations, we have discussed box type of machine foundations, and we have discussed your wall type. In last foundation we have discussed a wall type, and in this wall type of foundation we have two pairs of wall, and over these two pairs of walls we have a top slab and the machine rests on this top slab. Okay, last type of foundation is your framed type foundation. Generally in this frame type of foundation we consist of vertical columns having a horizontal frame at their top. Okay, and the machine is supported on this frame. Okay, this is a block type of machine foundation, this is a box type machine foundation, and this is your wall type, and this is your frame type. So we have till now discussed about introduction of your machine foundations. We have discussed about types of machine, and we have also discussed about types of machine foundations. Okay, so next topic in our lecture is your basic definition which are used in dynamic analysis of machine foundation. So first of all, we do not have to analyze but we have to just know about the basic definition that would be used in dynamic analysis of machine foundation. Okay, so first of all, the first definition is your vibration or oscillation. What does vibration and how it is being defined? So a vibration is being defined as it is a time dependent repeated motion of translational and or rotation type. So it is a type of motion which is dependent upon time and which is translation or rotational type. Okay, so when I would say translational, that means so the vibration means a type of repeated motion that can be translation or rotation, which is dependent upon the time. So when I would mean a translation, that means there would be a horizontal movement, and when I will describe rotational, then it would be a circular motion type of motion. Okay, so first definition was your vibration. Next one is your periodic motion. So how does a periodic motion is being defined? It is a motion which repeats itself periodically in equal time intervals. Okay, so when you have a motion that repeats itself in equal time interval, then you call that motion as periodic motion. And in which time interval it repeats itself, that time period is known as period, and that is defined as, or that is being designated as your T. Okay, so next definition is your cycle. So when the motion completed in the period is called as the cycle of motion. So for a certain period a motion will repeat after that T time duration only. So one motion is at for time T, next motion is for another that time T. So this for the first time period T, it is one cycle. Next time period T, it is another cycle. So when the motion completed in this period is called as cycle of motion. Next is your frequency. So the number of cycles of motion in a given unit of time. So for example, you have total duration of time is 12 hours and the period is of 1 hour. So what would be the frequency? The frequency would be 1 upon 12 upon 1. That means what would be the frequency in 12 unit of duration, how much cycles of motion has been done. And you already know that one cycle of motion is done in time t. So the number of cycles of motion in a given unit time is known as frequency of vibration, and it is generally usually expressed in hertz. And what is the relation between time period and frequency? T is equals to 1 by f. Now the next important term is your field vibrations, forced vibration, two terms. So when the vibration occurs under the influence of forces inherent in the system itself without addition of any external force, then it is called as free vibration. And when it is being occurred due to the influence of external force, it is called as forced vibration. So the both types of vibrations have different effects on the machine formation. So next is your natural frequency. The system under free vibration vibrates at the frequency known as natural. As the word suggests, what does the natural word mean? That is built from a system only. So the system which have free vibrations vibrate at a frequency which is known as natural frequency. Okay, so the natural frequency is the characteristics of the system, and the system may have one or more natural frequency. So the frequency is dependent upon how many cycles do you have in a particular unit time. So this may vary, and therefore it is written as a system may have one or more natural frequency. Next term is your resonance. When the frequency of the exciting force is equal to one of the natural frequency of the system. Okay, so that one is called your resonance. Generally, the natural frequencies are being occurred due to the natural vibrations. And when these natural frequency have some values, and when it matches from the frequency of the exciting force, then this condition is known as resonance. Because in this particular condition, the amplitude of the motion increases. Okay, so this particular analysis is also important, so that we can analyze that there are certain areas also where the amplitude may rise to a certain point. Okay, accordingly the machine foundation. Next one is your damping. The damping is defined as the resistance to the motion which develops due to friction and other cases. So generally the particular motion is being resisted by the development of friction and other cases. The last term in this particular definition portion is your degree of freedom. So the degree of freedom is being defined as the number of independent coordinates required to describe the motion of the system, which is known as degree of freedom. And why it is written as independent? As these are the coordinates which are not dependent on anything, neither it is dependent on the frequency nor it is dependent upon the time period, nothing. So the number of independent coordinate which describes the motion is called as the degree of freedom. So these are all the definitions that we require, that we need to know about the dynamic analysis of the machine formation: vibration, periodic motion, period, cycle, frequency, free vibration, force vibration, natural frequency, resonance, damping, degree of freedom, etc. So we all learnt about how is being machine foundation being described or being defined, the types of machines, the type of machine foundations, and the basic terminologies which we use in your machine found dynamic analysis of machine foundation. So this was all about machine foundations. Thank you and have a good day.